So I'm here to share with you the miracle that this COVID-19 virus is actually it's not our death wish, it's our will to live that it's come here. Because we've all known that we're in this major moment of needing to address climate change. And we've all been feeling it's impossible. Nobody's changing fast enough. We can't do it. Well, suddenly, we have met our emissions targets more than anybody could have imagined suddenly overnight, right? And so that wish to live, to address climate change, has just come true. And in this rainstorm, in this tiny little house with very little, you know, I don't need much energy here, electricity or whatever, it's a simple way to live, I feel in balance. But what we're seeing is this moment where you can see that if we can all stop as a world community, and we can all over the world just stop for a while, just hang in there and pray, that means we can invest in thorium research and technology development for totally clean energy with zero emissions. That's what thorium will give us, right? If we can all stay still for all this amount of time and longer and not be about money and materialism, we can revamp the jails so that there's no longer jail slavery and jail slavery for profit. We can. It's clear. If we can all stop, which we are doing now as a world community, to pray and take care of our health and take care of each other, we can feed each other, right? If we can all stop as we are accomplishing now, staying home as a world community, that means that we can have universal health care. We can have universal college and if we can send money to everybody to make it through this time, that means we can keep sending money. We can keep feeding and making sure that every single person in every job, in every circumstance, is housed and fed and has some money sent to them as the world changes over to more machines doing the jobs. You get it? So here you go. If we can stay here in our little spaces, incubating to protect our family and our friends so that we can go within, if we can do this, and we are doing this as a world community, that means we can shut down every fossil fuel power plant, we can shut down every coal plant, and we can immediately move over to clean, 100% clean energy through nuclear power. And if we can sit here quietly, come within, and the whole world stops, which we are accomplishing right now, that means we can accomplish clean nuclear energy. We already have the breakthrough plants from Russia, which are eating their own waste, and we know that nuclear power puts out zero emissions. We already know that thorium will allow us to have almost just incredibly clean energy happening, even though there is some waste to it. It eats its own waste even more than the power plants already are that the Russians have come out with. We can, if we can stay home, we can then change over to cars and transportation that's, you know, like trains and electric cars and bicycles. If we can be here together, quietly praying as a world community, that means we can have voting rights that are just in place, that are just really democratic, that are not tampered with, and then they don't change because of a person's region of you know, everybody's vote counts no matter where they live. We can revamp the Electoral College. Yes, if we can stay home as a world community, take care of our bodies and stop, and all of the skies go clear and blue, which is happening right now, and the oceans are getting clear again. If we can do this as a human species, then we can change the trajectory of global warming towards global cooling. okay? In a matter of weeks, we've made this huge change. Well, that would mean that in the next 10 years, not only can we make the Paris Agreement, we can go to the actual agreement, which the Paris Agreement isn't enough, you know? It's the actual agreement is the agreement with the laws of science that tell us how warm this planet can be and how cool it needs to be to have a future for all of us. So if we can be here in prayer and praying for the future of our children and the well-being of our bodies and the connectedness of all humans as one spirit, we all have the same needs for food and rest and peace and safety and love and connection and creativity and freedom and home and education and healthcare, transportation and beauty. We all have the same needs, so we can stop fighting. We can stop investing in weapons of mass destruction. We can stop buying guns, which is what all these people in Miami did. They heard about the crisis, so they go out and buy every gun in Miami. But if we can stay home and pray and be at peace and connect with, call each other and say, are you okay? Can I help you? That's what's really going on. Not this thing of looting and robbing that everybody's so afraid of. That's really not what's going to happen, guys. We're in a consciousness awakening right now, okay? So you're going to be so sad that you spent your money on that gun instead of on rice and beans to feed the very person you were afraid of. You're going to wish you could just invite that person in for soup. Okay? Sell the gun. Get some rice and beans, lentils, and things that you can add water to later. So you need to have 3 months worth of food in this time period. But we can feed each other. We can feed the neighborhood. If we can. When the Oakland Bridge collapsed and my mother was there, everybody said there was going to be massive looting and all those poor street people were going to take over the neighborhood. You know what they did? The street people, they were the ones digging in the rubble to get everybody out, along with the cops, okay? All the neighbors opened their doors and said, how are you? For the first time, people were talking to each other because we are more feminine than masculine, actually. It takes all the might that you have to force yourself into your masculine all the time because you're naturally more feminine. Whether or not you're a man or a woman, you were born with a pussy before your cock grew out of your clitoris. Seriously, that's a true fact. And we are social and we love to help each other and we love the excuse to be heroes, okay? So if we can be in this moment where all it's like silent night, peaceful, holy night, then we can re-envision the actual new Green Deal in every way of society, in every country, and we can hand back what we've stolen from so many countries, at least what America has stolen, the United States has stolen, you know, we can hand it back in gratitude that we are all still here and we're all waking up, okay? Wow, it's an amazing moment. I love being in this rainstorm in my little tiny house. Okay, love. Love life. Okay, love your life. Your life is worth it. You're in a transfigurative time. Every global thing I just spoke about for the world community, take that on the microcosm for your own life. You can have community now. It looks like the opposite, doesn't it? You can have creativity now. You can meet your goals of why you came here on Earth now. You can have health and rest now. You can have beauty and femininity supported now. You can have advocates who take who help you deal with bullies in your life. You can have protection now. You can move to a new place where you're safe. Okay? Welcome home to Eden. All right. Love life, darling.